Let's get started with forms. First, we are going to go to our new contact page. That's this page right here. Then, we can go to Insert, Classic, and we will have the Edit Form right here in the Popular section. Or we could go to the Input. Let's see. Yes, here, Edit Form. Those are the same. You can also add from this side pane here in this plus icon, going to Classic. Those controls are also here. I'm going to select Edit Form and then position the form here somewhere below the title and drag to have its height up to this point before the buttons. If we zoom in, we can see the message saying that this form is not connected to any data yet. It means the form needs to be connected to a data source, same way as we did to the gallery. So if I click here, it will show already the available data source in my app and I click on TB Contact. If this pop-up doesn't show, we can go to Data Source, the right pane, and select the TB Contact as well. Now, the message changed saying that there are no fields in this form and we need to add the fields. For some data sources, this might already show some inputs here, but for the Excel spreadsheet, it doesn't. So we need to go here to Edit Fields in this side pane, of course, with the form selected, click on it, and then click on Add Field. Now we need to add all the fields we want the form to show. In this case, I want the phone, name, phone, email, department, and comment. And then I click on Add. The fields now are going to appear in the form right here. Let's also rename the form with the form selected. Let's call FRM Contacts. Now we have a more intuitive name for the form. Right. Notice that if we want to change the order of the fields, we can do going back to Edit Fields and then we can move them. Let them just collapse, or I could click here and collapse all at once. And let's say I want the email to be the second input. So I just drag the email above the phone. See, it changed in the form. We can also change the type of input. For example, for the comment, I want to be a multiple line input. If I expand again the comment, we have control type configuration. And I can see here that we have the edit multi-line text. If I click on it, I can see that the comment input has already changed to be a multi-line input. Let's say now for department, I want to be a drop-down selection. So I can expand the department and change the type to allowed values. We can see that there is a drop-down here. Once I click, the drop-down will appear in there. Now we have the form configured, we can start creating a new record just to see how it works, and then we link to the other parts of the app. In the next video, we are going to learn how to do this and see a common mistake that beginners do. See you in there.